In this video, I'm going to give you a quick demonstration of common screen reader functionality by reading through this properly tagged PDF document. I'm using the NVDA screen reader, and I'm going to read through this document while having the tags pane open within Adobe Acrobat, since the tags pane, or more accurately the tags within it, determine how PDF contents are read by assistive technologies like screen readers. So, as I'm reading through this document, you're going to be able to see how what we're hearing from the screen reader matches what we have programmed in the tags pane. I'm going to start by reading through this document linearly, but pretty early on, I'm going to transition to having my screen reader seek out specific types of content. And these are two of the most common ways screen reader users interact with digital environments, where they'll either read linearly, forward, or sometimes backwards, or they'll seek out specific content or areas within the environment. Okay, so the first thing that we should have read within this PDF is that graphic there at the top.
You see Women's Initiative for Professional Development logo graphic.
Graphics actually use a figure tag, which is why you're seeing figure at the top of the tags pane, and what you're hearing from that graphic is actually the alt text assigned to it. Okay, so now I'm going to tell my screen reader to continue reading forward.
Heading level 12020, you see Women's Initiative for Professional Development, UCWI, Program Information and Nomination. Heading level 1 process.
So what actually occurred there is that screen readers have a character limit, as in a number of characters that they'll read for an element when given a single read forward command. And when you reach the end of that character limit, as we did right before the word process, you need to give your screen reader another command to have it continue reading forward. We heard heading 1 one more time there before process. That was just a reminder of how that element is tagged. If you look over in the tags pane, we only have one heading 1 tag there and not two. Okay, so now I'm going to tell my screen reader to continue reading forward. It's going to read that first paragraph of normal or paragraph text within the document. Paragraph text has a P tag with a paragraph icon.
UCWI is a unique, experiential professional development program offered to mid-career women.
Again, we've reached that character limit, so I'm just going to tell my screen reader to continue reading forward through this element.
Faculty, academic personnel, and staff who demonstrate the potential to advance their careers at UC.
And now I'm going to tell my screen reader to continue reading forward to the next element.
Heading level 2 purpose.
Okay, at this point, I'm going to start telling my screen reader to seek out specific types of content, starting with the next heading.
Sponsors and management heading level 2.
All right, now I'm going to tell my screen reader to seek out the next link.
List with 2 items system-wide advisory committee on the status of women link.
We heard list with 2 items there at the start. That was just letting us know what sort of content this link is within. And if you look over at the tags pane, you will indeed see that expanded L tag. That's this list. It's got 2 LI tags within it. The top one is expanded. And if you dig in there through all that nesting, you will see the system-wide advisory committee on the status of women link text, and beneath it, the link OBJR tag, which is what enables this link to be recognized by assistive technologies. Okay, now I'm going to tell my screen reader to continue forward to, let's say, the next list.
List with 2 items bullet mid-career faculty, academic personnel, and staff from campuses, health centers, division of.
You should see that list tag expanded in the tags pane towards the bottom, and it's got 2 LI or list item tags within it. How about I tell my screen reader to jump to the previous heading?
Target audience heading level 2.
Yeah, it's the target audience heading just above that list. Now I'm going to seek out the next table, which will jump us to the third page where that table is.
Table with 14 rows and 3 columns, row 1, column 1, page 3, start date.
Okay, I'm going to continue reading forward with my screen reader.
Column 2, end date.
And read forward one more time.
Column 3, activity.
And to just give you a sense of other ways that screen readers can read through tables, now instead of telling my screen reader to read forward, which would be that first empty cell within the start date column, I'm going to instead tell my screen reader to read down the column that it is currently within, that activity column.
Row 2 STM sends heads up information for locations to prepare for nomination process.
As we moved into that second row of the table, the screen reader let us know before reading the cell's contents. All right, one last thing I wanted to show you in this demonstration is the elements list. Let me bring it up.
Elements list dialog.
The elements list panel gives you a list of all the links within the document, as well as a list of all the headings. You can browse those lists and jump straight to any item within them. And when landmarks, buttons, and form fields are present in an environment, you'll be provided with lists of those as well. Again, giving you the capability of jumping straight to any particular one. All right, that's it. I hope this demonstration helped you better understand screen readers and how they function.